2011, our schools are more deep, are more segregated racially today than they were in 1968, 1967. So we held these town hall meetings. We also approached the Chamber of Commerce, that we understood funding CUEE about this. Reverend Rhodes and I met with them, and we shared our concerns with them about the expulsion rates, the suspension rates. And the other problem we have with American education is the students that perform well often perform well because they have the resources.
Right.
I mean, when we look at who gets Hope in Georgia, it's predominantly upper middle class people. That's why they get the B. So we have this irony, not to get off on Hope too much, that poor people who are scratching off lottery tickets are funding the education of the middle class and upper middle class. So to do well, you get the resources, you get the AP program, you get the IB program, you get the field trip, right? But the kids that need the resources the most rarely get them. So Purdue and other folks talk about social reproduction. So we have that problem here. But when we approached the chamber about this, when we began to hear about CUEE, we heard about, you know, $100,000 or plus. We heard about a research project that they commissioned with the University of Georgia. About studying the, well, at the time the language was consolidation, but now it's unification. And I say this with all kind of love for Reverend Bennett, you know, having a student. But they didn't really want to talk about it. In fact, Myrna Ballard, who is a friend and the wife of one of my colleagues, said that this isn't really the chamber's business. And it's not the chamber's mission. Now the problem we had with that was that graph you see in terms of the hyper-segregation we have now was created in part by the chamber. Specifically, the real estate industry and the banking industry in this community. Because they are the ones that took control and funded the growth. The real estate industry for years has been funneling people to the county. Right? It's COVID. We don't talk about white and black. But let's be clear, the Valdosta City School System is a black system. 78% black, as we see. The county system is the reverse of that. It is a predominantly white system with a small African American and a small Hispanic population. So the real estate folks and the lending institutions have helped create that. And it's a wonderful game to, you know, generate big money. It happened in my neighborhood on Los Angeles. I remember all the rumors that the real estate folks would say. As soon as people of color start moving in the community, you need to move out because the property values are going to do what? Go down. Right? So they create a new subdivision, they move you over there and fund it, and they create another one. As soon as people move up, like the Jeffersons, or the Jeffersons, right? So there's this kind of shell game that goes on. Certain people create a lot of benefits for that. So anyway, Warner said that they couldn't be a part of it. And we didn't understand that. We didn't understand. Specifically, the other thing Warner said was that CUEE was really the response of something the Industrial Authority had said. In particular, that we couldn't draw new folks here, specifically industry, because there was a perception of a white and black school system. Whether that's accurate or not in terms of what the Industrial Authority said, same folks that are bringing you biomass, same folks that want to bring you a private prison. That was the impetus we were told was behind the then consolidation effort. And we told them that we needed to change the language to the integration. We're really talking about integration.
Okay.
Now we're talking about unification. I know that sounds a lot better. Right? It sounds warm. Right? But time and time again, we ask questions that we can't seem to get answers to. CUEE has been at SCLC meetings. Some membership has changed. In particular, when it got brought up that the county wouldn't get to vote on this, that the only the city, the deal is that the city votes to give up its charter, and correct me if I'm wrong, George, the county will be forced to absorb it. Now think about the situation. If the county was predominantly white, and folks went to the county so they could be with predominantly white people, are left out of the vote, there wouldn't be a problem. So one of the things we raised when that was brought up to us is whether or not the community members thought that was democratic. Whether both sides would have a say. safe.